Hi, in this video we will discuss about PN junction diode. We will discuss about how depletion region forms. We will discuss about the current flow in forward diode condition, and we will discuss about current flow in reverse bias condition. Let us take n-type semiconductor in which we have majority charge carriers are electrons and we have minority charge carriers holes here. With each electron there is a one immobile positive ion exist. Similarly, in p-type semiconductor we can see there is a majority charge carrier holes in each case, and along with each hole there is an immobile negative ion exist, and there are few minority charge carrier electrons also available. When we form this p-type and n-type semiconductor together, the mobile ion exchanges at the junction and there is a recombination between electrons also happens, and immobile ions placed at their self. So as more and more electrons move from this side to this side and all are recombined, they left immobile ions nearby junction, and due to that there is a region which forms here. It is only available immobile ions nearby these regions, and it forms some sort of repulsions to the further movement. How? These are the immobile electrons in the p-type regions, these are the immobile positive ions in the n-type regions. Now when we try to connect our reverse bias condition, that is I am applying voltage to the diode less than 0 volt, so I can set as a negative volt. So p-type is connected to negative of the battery and n-type is connected to positive of the battery. So this situation we refer as a reverse bias. So during reverse bias, if we see the carefully what happens, the electron in n region gets strong attraction field towards this positive terminal of battery, and similarly the holes of p regions are filled by the electrons supplied by this battery. So there is a more immobile ions exist here, and there is a more immobile positive ions exist here. So it will increase the depletion region in both the sides, and further there is a no communication happens between these electrons, will jump from here and reach here, and holes can be filled by these electrons. So circuit is not get completed because depletion region becomes larger and larger. As depletion region becomes large, there is a strong resistance provided in the reverse bias, and there is almost nil current flow because of majority charge carrier. Now there are some minority charge carrier exist. In n type there are few holes available, and in p type there are few electrons available. So this electron gets strong attraction towards this positive higher reverse bias voltage, and this hole gets strong attraction towards this negative terminal of battery. So due to that, some amount of current will flow, that is called minority charge carrier current. And minority charge carrier current is very small in amount because charge carriers are very less in numbers. So usually it flows in nanoamperes. So when it goes high, that is depend on temperature. Let us say if temperature is 17 degree centigrade at present and the current flow is 1 nanoampere. If there will be a rise in temperature nearby diode by 10 degree, the leakage current or the reverse bias current will goes double. So this current due to minority charge carrier is also called reverse bias saturation current. It is also called leakage current. So these are the name of the current flow in a reverse bias: leakage current or reverse bias or reverse saturation current. So practically there is no significant amount of current flow in the reverse bias. So in negative or reverse bias diode we cannot get any conduction of current. These things will help us to work diode as a switching. Let us take another case in which we will connect diode with the supply such that our voltage is greater than 0. So P is connected to positive, N is connected to negative of supply. This condition is called forward bias condition. In forward bias condition, the depletion region which forms because of PN region, what will happen when we connect to forward bias, when we are applying this voltage in a increasing fashion, let's say 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, up to 1 or say 1.5. So when we are increasing voltage 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 volt, few electrons at 0.3 and 0.4 volt, very less in number, but few electrons get strong attraction field towards this positive of the supply. And hence we can see here some amount of current will flow, that is very, very less, almost nil, we can say nanoampere or microampere. After 0.5, there is some amount of electrons will attracted here, but the sufficient amount or the actual current conduction which we refer will start at 0.7 volt. Practically, it will start anywhere between 0.6 to 0.7 volt, which is referred as a knee voltage or cut-in voltage, from where the current will flow significantly. Then after, when we increase the voltage, current will further flow in very large amount. By applying the small difference of voltage after knee voltage, current flow will be larger. So that is the characteristic of forward bias. So here we can see in forward bias, after 0.7 volt, current will conduct, and voltage less than 0.7, we can neglected amount of current will be there, and voltage less than even 0 in reverse bias, almost current is nil. So this possibility will help us to work in a diode for the switching applications. So when we want to apply the current, we can put the condition in diode greater than 0.7 volt. When we want to stop current, it should be less than 0.7 volt or in reverse bias. In next lecture, we will discuss about how static and dynamic resistance can be calculated from the characteristic curves of I versus V. Thank you.